Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. In the last video, I talked about the linear correlation coefficient. And I wanted to say at the beginning of a video, when you're actually paying attention, that correlation does not imply causation. A good example is that the rates of violent crime and ice cream sales have been shown to have a strong correlation, meaning that as ice cream sales increase, violent crime increases also. Should we then conclude that ice cream sales cause violent crime? Should cities ban the sale of ice cream? And hopefully, rationally, you're saying no. It's not the ice cream sales that are causing violent crime. It's not the violent crime that causes ice cream sales. Something else is causing a rise in those two things. And that's what we'd want to investigate to figure out the cause. But when both one goes up, the other goes up. It could just be that violent crime increases in summertime and ice cream sales increase in summertime, and that's why they're correlated. Because they're correlated does not imply that one causes the other. That's a really important thing to remember. If conducting a formal hypothesis test to determine if there is a significant linear correlation between the two variables, use p equals 0 for your null hypothesis. P equals 0 suggests there's no correlation. And H(1) is your alternative hypothesis, should be P does not equal 0. That would imply that there is correlation. These hypotheses use P to represent the linear correlation coefficient of the population. This is a formula for the test statistic. If you know what your R, that's your linear correlation coefficient. If you know that and you know the number of pairs in your data set, you can fill this out and find that. We are going to use technology, so I'm not going to spend a lot of time going through that formula. We can compare the test statistic to the critical values to make decisions about the claim. If the test statistic is in the rejection region, we reject the null and conclude that there is a linear correlation because we said that the null means that there is no correlation. So if we reject it, then we have to say there is a correlation. Otherwise, we fail to reject the null hypothesis. That means there's no correlation. Okay, here's an example. A data set includes scores for math and English tests from 32 students. The paired scores of math and English tests were used to obtain the results shown below. Is there sufficient evidence to support the claim that there is a linear correlation between the scores of math and English tests? Use a significance level of 0.05. In this problem, I'm not asking you to calculate anything. I want asking you just to make a decision. So the correlation matrix is for math and English are our variables. For English and math, the correlation is 0.1282. That's the correlation score. Determine the null and alternative hypothesis. As I stated before, we're always going to use p equals 0 for null and p does not equal 0 for the alternative. Identify the test statistics, which in this case is the correlation coefficient R, and we can just get that from the matrix and get 0.1282. Always check to see what your instructor or what your homework program is asking you to round to. It may not be asking you to go to four places. Then identify the critical values, and here's the table, and that table is available to you in your homework as a drop-down, so you can go right to that table. We have 32, which means the closest we're going to get to with that is 30, and then we had 0.05, so we just go over here, 0.05 down to 30, and I've already underlined it ahead of time, 0.361 is our critical value. And this is two-tailed because we were saying does not equal to, so our critical values are plus or minus 0.361. And we compare that to our test statistic. And we always compare the absolute value of the test statistic and the positive value of our critical value. So 0.1282 is less than 0.361. Since it's smaller than, the absolute value of our test statistics is less than or equal to the positive critical value, there is not sufficient evidence to support the claim that there is a linear correlation between the weights of math and English test scores. So we say we cannot see a correlation in that data. And finally, if you're asked to make a scatter plot or find a correlation coefficient, for my class, use the StatCrunch program. There's a video on how to do that. Any calculator that you want to do that on, you can find on YouTube. You can find a video on how to do that. Once you find your correlation coefficient, remember to look at the value to determine if a correlation exists. The closer to one, the stronger the correlation. All right, we'll talk about regression in our last video. Have a fantastic day.